Right now, we're bringing back Assemblyman David Hadley to the John and Ken Show, the Republican from Torrance.
Part of the funding for the high-speed rail debacle is from what they call cap-and-trade money. This is the global warming tax on businesses. And it's, you know, runs up into the billions of dollars over the years. And Jerry Brown wants to siphon off some of that global warming tax and give it over to high-speed rail. Well, Assemblyman David Hadley is going to explain here why he may not be able to do that. Let's talk to him. David, welcome back to the show. How are you?
I'm great, guys. John, Ken, how you doing?
Good. No, we're good.
He's a Republican from Torrance.
And we're looking at your news release here, and of course, you go through the history of this. In 2014, the legislature passed Senate Bill 862, which provided that 25% of all cap-and-trade dollars must go towards benefiting low-income Californians. With 60% of the state's disadvantaged communities in Southern California, the change in route for a high-speed rail effectively makes this requirement impossible to meet, because what David's going to talk to us about is that, of course, they have allocated a chunk of cap-and-trade money to try to fund this loser, California's high-speed rail, because it's way short of funding. This was just a last-ditch effort by the legislature to keep the ball rolling. In fact, I know down the road, David, they actually want to borrow against future cap-and-trade monies as a way to say, look, we got money, investors. We're doing great, which they're not.
That's right. They do not have enough money to complete the project, so they're trying to borrow against future tax revenues to say they have enough money.
All right, so explain how this part would work with this cap-and-trade money, because we did do the news, and you know well more about it. The change in route apparently is going to affect this. They are no longer going to build the first operating segment coming down here to Southern California. They're going to do it up in the Central Valley into San Jose or Silicon Valley.
Correct. So the High-Speed Rail Authority announced a few weeks ago that they were just going to not do it in L.A. They were going to do it from between San Jose and the northern end of the Central Valley. And as we discussed a couple weeks ago, so you may have heard it, that might be a better idea than trying to drill through the Tehachapis here in North L.A. But a regional Northern California program funded by cap and trade money is inconsistent with the law, and they don't have the money to do it. They do not have the cap and trade revenues to do this. The way this works, if you want to give me just a second, the way
sure.
It works is in 2014, when this money was allocated, and when these cap and trade funds were allocated to the high speed rail project, the High Speed Rail Authority committed to building the Southern California route first, because we have a disproportionate number of low-income residents, disadvantaged communities in Southern California, and a quarter of cap-and-trade money is supposed to be dedicated to those communities. And building an L.A. first was part of the way to meet that commitment.
Can I just ask you a question?
Sure.
What does high-speed rail have to do with poor people?
Well, this is mission creep. This is government in action. First, we
poor people aren't going to be taking a train to San Francisco.
So first we implement cap and trade and generate all these funds. It's supposed to be used to reduce carbon. Then the legislature has committed that 25% of that should go to disadvantaged communities. Frankly, whether that's the most efficient way to achieve reductions in carbon emissions or not. So it's a distortion of the original intent of cap and trade to begin with.
And then they come up with a magical rationalization. Well, this train's going to help poor people.
That's right. That's right. And then even after they've done that to get the legislature to approve allocating these funds to the high-speed rail project, then they just changed the route a couple years later.
And isn't this a very long-winded way of saying they've come up with a way to steal money?
Yeah. Every year this project changes because it doesn't make any sense. It has to keep moving. If anybody actually looked at the project for more than a couple months, it would be dead as a doornail. So this is like a magic show. You're always putting something in one pocket, taking it out of the other ear. And the latest trick is it's not Palmdale. It's not the L.A. route. It's suddenly San Jose to the northern Central Valley.
So if they built this segment from the Central Valley to San Jose, and the rationale is there's a lot of workers.
They would use it as a commuter line.
Right, because San Jose is so expensive that the ordinary workers,
like the cubicle people maybe that work in Silicon Valley, sometimes live in the Central Valley, and they could take
the
high-speed rail that distance up to work.
Yeah, they can't afford to live in San Jose.
Which really has nothing to do with high-speed rail. We didn't raise all this bond money to build a commuter line.
So what is it? Is that going to be the extent of the rail line, and that's it?
Well, See, this train, the first thing everybody needs to understand, this train's never going to get built because it doesn't make any sense. What they're trying to do is put enough points on the board so that the public in California will say, you know, this thing may be a loser, but we've come so far, we might as well finish it. That's what they're trying to do.
How far could that go in your thinking, though? Could it go beyond that first operating segment that they want to build that they've now revised on?
It's until the legislature is finally prepared to pull the ripcord on this loser stop providing the additional funding.
All right, should we be voting and be rooting for Gavin Newsom because he's running for governor and he is actually not big on high-speed rail?
You know, Gavin Newsom has come out, you know, not a fan of high-speed rail. My personal prediction is that all serious candidates for governor from both parties will have disavowed high-speed rail by election time, and the next governor will witness, will preside over the closing of this turkey. And maybe a Northern California regional rail line will have come out of it, but that shouldn't be built with statewide cap-and-trade money. That should be Bay Area money.
So what you're saying here, though, I mean, is this going to get any leverage in Sacramento that they can't use this cap-and-trade money now that they've changed the route for the first operating segment based on what you've laid out? Will anybody care beyond you and a few other Republicans?
Well, so what I've introduced, the specific legislation I have introduced, is that the cap-and-trade revenue that the High-Speed Rail Authority has forfeited by changing the route from the southern route to the northern route should be reallocated to what residents in California really need, which is local transportation, which is roads and transit. And those projects are disproportionately in Los Angeles. So this would return cap-and-trade dollars to its originally intended purposes and would also support much more development of, actually workable transportation options for Southern Californians. And I do think more than just a few Republicans will care about this. More and more legislators, both Democrat and Republican, are uncomfortable. The Democrats are getting weak in the knees, many of them, on this high-speed rail project because they know what a turkey it is. And I'm hoping that this bill, this legislation, will be a rallying cry for Southern Californians who may have supported high-speed rail because it was going to generate jobs and projects in their districts. Now that's not even happening. You know, their residents are paying gas taxes or paying cap-and-trade fees, which are now going to be spent on the San Jose line. Let's keep the jobs, let's keep the revenue in Southern California, and let's actually build something that people might use.
Yeah. All right. Well, we appreciate you coming back on. Good stuff. Thanks. Assemblyman David Hadley from Torrance.
Happy to be back. Thank you, guys.